In this video, let's explore some simple finish machining operations on this bicycle suspension arm. After being cast, the part gets prepped on one machine so it can be mounted to a fixture on a 5-axis machine. Here, some features will be finish machined, after which the part will get deburred to remove any sharp edges or casting slag before being sent out for powder coat. Let's take a look at two finishing operations that are programmed on the outside of the part. Backplotting these operations, you see that it does one pass around the part, followed by a second, lighter finish pass from each side. Due to the tighter radius of these through pockets, a small diameter tool is required. The fixture design limits the depth of these cuts. Because of this, there are two portions of the center structure that are not getting finish machined. Another operation will be required utilizing a longer tool. I'll use this second operation as a source by copying it below. Click Geometry for the operation and rechain all. First, I'll pick a segment of chains on the left side of the part using the edges selection method. Next, I'll select this single chain on the right of the part. The issue here is that this chain will cause the tool to contact the part much sooner than is needed. Instead, select Dynamic Start Point. This allows for dynamic adjustment of the start or the end of the chain. Notice that the start arrow now highlights when hovering over it. Although not an issue here, it can be very helpful in cases where the start and end of the chain are in close proximity, or you have a 3D chain and are in a view that causes the arrows to overlap in the graphic screen. Click and slide the arrow over. New in Mastercam 2022, selection of auto cursor positions that do not lie on the selected chain are allowed. When I click on the center point of this pocket edge, the start arrow snaps to the point on the chain at a perpendicular intersection to the selection. This adjusted chain should give us the results needed in this application. But if after simulating I discover that I need to move the start or end point, I can relaunch the geometry and adjust the chain in the same fashion. End chaining and relaunch the parameters of the toolpath. On the tool page, select the 16mm 5xD tool. Since this is a much longer tool, I'll back off on the cutting parameters to eliminate chatter. 5000 RPM and a feed of 3000 mm per minute fall safely inside the manufacturer's recommended range. Clicking on multi-passes, I'll also cut the finish pass parameters by half. New for Mastercam 2022 is the ability to override feeds and speeds for your finish pass. Activating the option for feed, I will drop it to 2500 mm per minute to be at the lower range of the manufacturer spec for an even better finish. To accomplish this in previous releases of Mastercam, I would have been forced to either slow my roughing passes, wasting valuable cycle time, or create a separate operation to finish the part. Lastly, go into the linking parameters and adjust the depth of cut. I need to be sure that the tool reaches all the way to the bottom of the cut from the other side. Set the Z to the edge of the fixture. Rounding this off to negative 23 millimeters should be sufficient. Click OK and the toolpath will regenerate. To ensure that the blends between tools are behaving as expected, let's simulate the actual stock removal using Mastercam Verify. Verify stock setup is referencing the stock model representing the cast part. Select all three contour operations and launch Verify. Let Verify run all the way through to the end. Examining the part, it's clear that our newly programmed operation with the longer tool should yield a nice blend along that face with the other pre-existing operations. From here, we are ready to proceed with programming the rest of the finishing operations and then deburr the part. Be sure to check out the other video in this series where I will show you how to break the edges on this suspension component. Mastercam 2022's improved deburr technology makes this easier than ever to do all in one setup on the machine.